Welcome, Representative Lancia, and I appreciate you coming in. I know that you've just had recent surgery, so.
Yes, trying to do the job, third shoulder replacement, former Navy chaplain disabled vet, and I appreciate it. You had pain tolerance. I'm only a week out of surgery, so I appreciate the opportunity to go a little sooner. This is a bill that I think is a fairly simple bill. It's in relationship to an incident that I think everybody heard about, where a child who had been given a tray of food, they went to the register, and when they got to the register, the tray of food was taken from them after it was shown that they didn't have enough money in their account. So, you know, I looked for something to do, and I had heard about a United States Senate bill that was had been put in, and you have a copy of it, Senate Bill 1064. That's the United States Senate bill. And it was a very simple bill, actually. Basically, what the bill says is that once a tray of food is given to a child, it cannot be taken away. That the child cannot be tagged with a stamp on their hand or something on their wrist to identify them as somebody that's different than anybody else. That also, they can't be forced to do additional chores or singled out for any other reason. And that the bottom line is that a note or some form of correspondence after that will go home to the parents to notify them of the balance. So it's a fairly simple bill. I think it's a bill, you know, we talk about, bullying of children, never mind, you know, children looking at other children that aren't the same as them, that are treated differently, and they become, you know, the butt of jokes and things like that. But this bill is also important for another reason, because I worked very closely with Angelina Penta from Jell's Kitchen. And you may have heard that inspiring story, because this has become an inspiring story. Her and her husband, Michael Penta, own Jell's Kitchen. They also own another pizza business in Warwick. And Angelica took it upon herself to try to address the situation by getting donations and raised some decent money. Not enough to solve the entire problem. And she started in West Warwick, and she and I had a very, very good conversation with the superintendent of schools of West Warwick, as well as their business manager. They assured us that this would not be the case there anymore, but there are 38 other cities and towns, and we just want to make sure that this won't happen again to any other child. So Angelica is here, and she is going to speak, but also what she's done, and we've now talked about possibly creating a nonprofit to raise money to be able to expand this program, and I'm going to be working with her. We were even reached out to by a gentleman who is a district manager for Stop and Shop who wants to be involved. He sits on the Rhode Island Food Bank board. So, I mean, this has got legs, it's growing, and I think it's an important initiative. And I love the fact that it's also being held in, this hearing's being held in HEW and not House Finance, because there's no state tax dollars involved. And so for that reason, I think it's a good bill too. This is a bill that I think can make a difference. And so that's the basis on which this bill has been done. And I look forward to your support and any questions that you have.